Hello guys, welcome to my this video, and in this video just I will show how you can use reactive form validation. And guys, here I want to show one thing, that is I already made a video about reactive form validation, but guys, here something is updated. If you use my that reactive form validation whatever I made previously, so guys, you will get an error, that is object is possibly null. So guys, here I will show you how you can do that, and that is updated. So here in this video I will do from begin. Okay, so guys, here you can see I already open app module.ts file, home component html, home component ts and css file, because guys, here in the home component just I will use my reactive form. Okay, and guys, when we use reactive form, that time we are to import, that is forms module and reactive forms module, and that comes from Angular forms. Okay, that is pre-default. So guys, that's not changed. So guys, here you have to be import this line, forms module, F is the capital of forms and M is the capital of module, and here you can see the reactive forms module, R is the capital, F is the capital and M is the capital also, and it comes at the rate Angular forms. And guys, when we import any module, that we are to inject in our imports array. So I will scroll down here, this is the imports array. So if you already open your appmodule.ts file, so here you will find this imports array. So here you have to be inject all the module name, so that denote that is your module you imported. So you have to be imports, I mean inject this module reactive and forms module in our import array. Okay, here is the forms module and reactive forms module, so these two you have to be imports here. So after again I'm showing that after imports this line and import this two module, now just I will do the next process. I think you have completed this one, and now I will close this appmodule.ts file, and inside this home, so first of all I will show my preview. Here is the preview. Okay, so now homeworks, so here just I will create a form. So guys, for that here I will write a section class, just I will add some CSS. If you don't want to look at this, so you can skip this one. Okay, so first here I will add some CSS. So suppose this is registration form, so I have missed the spelling, so registration. Okay, and now here I will write deep class container, this is bootstrap class container, and now just here I will write my form. So I can do one thing, form FRM form, sorry guys, FORM form, and I can write a class FRM, this one, and now here I can define a input field. So here I can write this way, input type is text. First just I will show one field validation, after that I will show how you can validate password also. Password means guys, here there are two types of password, confirm password and confirm password. So we know guys, when we write password and confirm password, that should be matched. So this validation I will show you in the next, and after that another video that I will show you the dynamic validation also. But here first of all I will show the basic. Okay, so here you can see I have written input type text. So now guys, just here I will save, and here you can see this is form. So here you can do one thing, that is placeholder. Placeholder I can write user name. Okay, and name I can write username. Okay, so now let's check it, this one, and now here just I will add some CSS. So I can do one thing, that is I will copy this registration class, and here I can write this, and now I can write position. So guys, I can do one thing, I don't need to write here class. Okay, I will do So guys, now just in the CSS I will write position fixed width. So guys, if you don't want to watch this CSS design part, so you can skip also. So guys, width 40%, and now here just I will write padding 30 pixel. Just simple CSS I will add background this FF white color, and just here I will add some little bit of gray color, border 1 pixel, solid, and again just I will little bit of dark. And guys, here let's check it once. I will write top is 50%, left is 50%, and the another thing, translate -50%, -50%, and now let's check it. So you can see our form is ready here. So now here I will do another thing, that is here just I will write classes input. Okay, so now I will copy this input class, and here I will write just width 100%, padding 10 pixel. So let's check it once. You can see, okay, so now here a light border. Now when I'm clicking on that, so you can see it's doing outline. So I want to remove this outline. So how can do that? So just here a light input colon focus outline none. So when I will focus on this input, so their outline will be none. So now you can see that, and now it's done. So now just here I'll do a button. So button type is submit, and class is button, and now button name is submit. And guys, here I can do one thing, I can write div class text center. Sorry guys, text center so now first look at once. So here you can see it submit is on the text because center, because here I have written a bootstrap class text center. Okay, now I will copy this button class, and just here I will add some CSS. So that is padding is 10px, 20px, background color I will use this color, anything, just a color I will add, border radius 2 pixel. Okay, so let's check it once. So here you can see it's coming this way. So just I will add margin top 10 pixel, and here I will add 30 pixel, color I will add white, font weight 600. So you can see submit. Just I will place a padding here, top and bottom padding I will add 8, and left and right 30 pixel. And now when I will hover on this button, so hover, so that time just I will little bit of just little bit of dark. So guys, here this one, and guys just here transition 0.4 is okay. Is means, guys, I'm showing what is the meaning of is. So you can see, is means when I will hover on it, so it will transition 0.4 and when I will hover out, so it will the same thing, transition will be 0.4. So that is the meaning is. If I remove is from here, so guys, let's check it once. Okay, so when I'm hover on it, so you can see it's not transition, it's or just directly it's add the background color dark, but when I'm hover out, so that time its transition is added. So is means when I will hover and when I will hover out, so both the time it will be at the transition. Okay, so that is the is. So now design part is completed, and now guys, here I will close this one, and now just here I will show error message. So but before that, in the form here I will write on ng submit. So ng submit, when we write click hover event, so same way ng submit. Ng submit means that denotes this button. Okay, so here you can write also click function inside this button, but if you write ng submit inside this form tag, that means which button type will be submit, so that button's click event will be fired. Okay, so here I will write ng submit. So here the method name is on submit. Method name you can write as per your choice, it's not mandatory, but the event you have to be right ng submit. And if you write ng submit, so here is the button type is submit. So you can write, you cannot write here two button types submit. Okay, you have to be just write one button type submit, that will be denote our this method. I mean, here you can write ng submit, that will be denote this button, because you have written the type is submit on this button. Otherwise you can remove from here. Okay, and now here you can write click method also this way, click and the method name, you can do that, but it's good practice. Okay, here you should write ng submit, this is good practice. And now guys, here you have to be write a form guru. So form group, F is the small letter and G is the capital. And now reactive form. Okay, so form group is the reactive form. So when I am writing here the form group, that means here how many input will be here, so that will be a group. So that's why it's a form group. That means suppose in this component, suppose you have a two form, so that this form is a reactive form group, and when it will be, you will be at, suppose here is the another form, suppose in the one page you have registration and login, so there is the two form group, registration and login. So this is the form group. And now here guys, when I have written a form group, so here I have, now I will show a error message. So error message is div and star ng if equals to, and guys, now here I will write a variable, that is submitted. Submitted is the variable name. You can write any name of the variable as per your choice. And now, and if dot username, okay, dot username dot error. So if is also a variable name, you can write So guys, you can write any name instead of F also. And now if username is error, so now what I will do, just here again I will write div star ngf equals to, and now inside this ngf just again I will write f dot username dot errors dot require. Okay, so when our username will be error, so that time I will show the username is required also, and here I will show the message that is username is required. Okay, I hope you have understand it. Submitted is the variable and if is also a variable. So what is the use of submitted and if, I will show you in the next. So now here our error message is completed. And now in the TS file, inside this TS file, the first thing you have to be import. So import. Okay, so what you have to be import, you have to be import form group comma form control. So just check the spelling here guys also. F is the capital and G is the capital of form group. Here is the F and C is the capital of form control. And now validators. So just don't miss the spelling here, otherwise you will get a error. And now form builder, and this comes from @ angular / forms. Okay, and now in the constructor, just you have to be create a instance. So what instance? Private form builder. So this form builder is the object. So when we create an instance, if you know guys about the oops concept, so there is the oops concept, like this is the class, and you can see the class is home component. Okay, so here is the class is home component, and inside this home, this class, when we create a object and this object we want to use in another component, so that time we have to create a instance. So same way, the form builder is the class that form builder is the object inside this class. So this form builder we want to use. So guys, that time we have to be create an instance, and this form builder definition is written in another page. Okay, so this page is coming on forms, and now this form builder instance I have to be create. So now is the I have create an instance. So instance name is form builder. F is the small here I have written. You can write any name of this instance. Instance is also like a variable. We don't use directly this one, form builder. So we just create a variable that is instance of this. And now I have done here. And now here, now I have to do that is just here. I will write here this reactive form. Okay, so this is the type of form group. So here this form group. Okay, now it's showing error. Why it's error? Property reactive form has no initializer. So when we it's a changed also. Okay guys, so that's why I'm making this video from begin, because guys, when we define up any variable, so now it's changed, you have to be assign any value here, otherwise you have to be define it in constructor. So just I will define it in constructor. So the here just I will write, so I can do one thing, I will write this one not here, I will write here, both are You have remember that is I have written a submitted variable. So first of all, this submitted variable type is boolean equals to, and the first of all here I will write the type is false. And now guys, here just I will add the definition of this reactive form. So this dot reactive form equals to this dot form builder. Form builder means I have created an instance. So form builder dot group. Now okay, so just look at my syntax, what I am writing here. So form builder and dot group. So whatever I will write, that will be create a group. So what I will write here inside this form group, or how much input here, so that I will create a object. So guys, first of all here, if you have remember, this input is the name is input. So when we use reactive form, so here we write form control. So guys, here I will write con form control name equals to this name username. So here you have to be write the same name of the form control. So username form control spelling is F is small, C is capital, and N is capital also. So now I will copy this username and here I will write. Okay, now new form control, and just I will create a object. So now here, first of all, null and square bracket, inside the square bracket just I will write validators dot required. Okay, so validator is this one already I have imported. So this validators dot required. So when our form control will be null, so that time I will write here it's a required. So now here I will do that is outside this constructor. This is the constructor, and outside this constructor here I will write get f. So when we use get keyword, when we want to get any object property, so that time we use get keyword. Okay, so inside this f variable I will get the object property is, that is method curly braces return this dot reactive form controls. So I will returning the controls of this reactive form. This reactive form means here is the reactive form which I have added inside this form. And now inside this f variable I'm getting all the reactive forms controls. Controls means here is the input, so all the inputs have a control. Control is valid, invalid, this control. So this control I'm getting inside this a variable. And now for the error message showing purpose I have used this control. So error, invalid, I can use this control here. Okay, so now I have done this, and now here you can see I have written submit method name is on submit. So I will copy this on submit method and here I will paste here. So now here I will write here this dot submitted equals to 2. So when I will click this method or this button, so here it's showing error because I did not save here. So guys, here if I save this one, so error will be removed. So it's removed. So when I will click this submit button, so that time this variable will be true. And now here I will write a condition, that is, so this dot reactive form dot invalid. So if all the reactive form means here everything inside this form, whichever I will write, I mean how much input type I will write here. So if these are the invalid, so that time it will return our error. Return our error means whatever I have defined this error here, so that will be return. So now our form is done. So just now here if I click, so you can see username is required. So I can do one thing, that is just error message here I can write a class it error, save, and just CSS. Inside this CSS I will add error color. Error color is this red color. Okay, so color this. So now if I click without filling this input submit button, so you can see username is required. And now if I suppose here if I fill anything, so you can see error is gone. And now if I click submit button, it's not showing error, because when the username field will be blank, so that time I will get error. Okay, so hope guys this validation you have understand. And the next one I will show how you can validate password and confirm password validation. That means if the password should be 123 and the confirm password 1 and only 2, so that time password and confirm password did not match, so that time we should write a validation. So that validation I will show you in next video. And hope guys this video is helpful to you. And if you want to get this type of more video, so please subscribe and press the notification bell icon also.